Hello everyone, myself Neha Gupta, your mentor for current affairs. Today I am going to teach you some questions that can be of use for your RBI, SEBI and NABARD examinations. And at last, we have the GK Factory section to discuss some of the most interesting as well as relevant topics. So let's begin this video. But before that, if you are a newcomer here, so let me inform you that this PDF is downloadable. You just have to go to our Telegram channel and the link of the channel is in description below. So let's begin with the first question. Which state has partnered with the NPCI and SBI for implementing e-rupee for the payment of scholarships to students in the state? So guys, here the right answer is Karnataka. Now I hope that you are a bit aware about the background of e-rupee initiative. So first of all, it was launched last year only by the Union Government of India. And the basic purpose was to eliminate the transfer of money into the bank accounts of the beneficiaries. Instead, the center aimed to just give the beneficiaries the direct acquisition of the goods. Okay, so through this e-rupee, the government is going to send the link or the SMS for the feature phones. Then the beneficiaries who are getting this link or the SMS will go to the merchant and acquire the good, okay, by showing them the link or the SMS that they have got from the government. So this is the e-rupee. Now this merchant has already got its payment from the government. So this is the whole idea, just to eliminate the money in this entire chain and just giving them the link and SMS. So this was to stop the corruption in the intermediary level and also to target the segment for which the amount is being given. For example, it has been seen that the amount is being given for fertilizer consumption, but some farmers tend to spend that money on their alcohol. So ultimate goal is not being served. But now, since this link or SMS is being given through the e-rupee, so the beneficiary can only spend the money, the amount for which he or she is entitled to, at the good for which he or she has gotten that link or SMS. So I hope that this much is clear to you. So that's the entire e-rupee initiative. And right now, Karnataka has signed this, basically partnered with NPCI and SBI for transfer of scholarship money to the students in the state. So that's the entire news all about. So basically through the e-rupee, the fees, education fees, will be paid digitally to the college and institutions by the state government. So that's the entire idea behind this collaboration. Moving ahead, which state has launched a health service management center for monitoring various national and state level health schemes? So here the right answer is Gujarat. So basically through this HSMC, the state government of Gujarat is going to monitor the central and state level health schemes. Okay, so that's the idea. Now under this HSMC only, Health Service Management Center only, the Gujarat Epidemic Response Management Information System, which is short formed as GERMIS. Okay, so guys, directly this would not be given in your question. Probably they can ask you this thing, that which state has launched this GERMIS, GERMIS portal. Now you need to know that it is Gujarat that has launched this, and the basic purpose of this portal is to assess the availability of beds, the availability of oxygen and ventilators at the hospitals, because unfortunately the third wave is knocking at our doors. So that's why this state is just preparing itself for the worst case scenario. Okay, as far as this slide is concerned, so guys, this is just mentioning the names of the schemes that are being monitored through this Health Service Management Center, which you can read on your own as well. Which state has established a Kaushal Rozgar Nigam for providing contractual manpower to all government entities in a transparent, robust and equitable manner? So here the right answer is Haryana. Now recently the portal of this Nigam, Haryana Kaushal Rozgar Nigam, has been launched by the government of Haryana. And because of that, this is in the news. So this Nigam basically was incorporated under the Companies Act of 2013 in the month of October 2021. So very latest it is, and right now we are seeing the portal of this being launched. So what is the purpose of this Kaushal Rozgar Nigam? The basic purpose of this portal or this organization is to provide all kind of contractual labor to the government, okay, at all levels. So this is going to act as the authorized agency for providing the contractual manpower to the government entities in Haryana. Also, an Atal Park and Smriti Kendra was established in Gurugram. So do remember this as well. Vyavastha Parivartan Se Sushasan. So this was a magazine that was launched by the Haryana government on Good Governance Day. So do remember that this was launched by the Haryana. Okay, so this can be asked, and CM Window is the portal through which the public can directly contact the CM and get their queries resolved. So this is also in Haryana. Next is on which river is Dhaula Sidh Hydro Power Project being developed? So here the right answer is Bias. A number of hydropower projects have been recently inaugurated, not exactly inaugurated, basically their foundation stones have been laid. So yesterday only I taught you about the Renuka Ji hydroelectric power, the power project that is being developed on the Giri River, which is a tributary of Yamuna. Okay, so at the same ceremony, the Prime Minister of India had laid the foundation stones for these hydropower projects also. So let's have a look at these projects. First one is this Dhaula Sidh Hydro Project, which is on Bias River. It is going to be the first dam in this Hamirpur district of Himachal Pradesh. So no need to pay attention to this thing particularly. Next is Luhri Stage 1 Hydropower Project, which is going to be built on Satluj River. Savra Kudu Project on Pabbar River, which is again a tributary of Yamuna. So we have discussed two tributaries. One is Giri, on which Renukaji Dam is being built, and the other one is this Pabbar River, on which this Savra Kudu hydropower project is being built. Do remember, both of these are in the news, and the high chances are there that you can expect the notification of RBR SEBI in the coming months. So all these things make this month very important for you. So do prepare these kinds of news thoroughly. Sunni Dam on Satluj River. For this also, the foundation stone was laid down. Now, all of these dams are going to be developed by the Satluj Jal Vidyut Nigam at a cost of 11,000 crores. So that was all regarding this news. Which of the following banks has recently launched the green fixed deposits? So here the right answer is option E, IndusInd Bank has launched this, and the basic purpose of this initiative is to use the money that they will get from the borrowers, that they will get from the depositors who will fix deposit their money to lend to the projects, to the firms that are engaged in the sectors that are helpful in UN's sustainable development goals. Okay, so this is basically a contribution by the IndusInd Bank towards the sustainable development goals. Now, these are the benefits that the people would get in order to do a green fixed deposit. So they will get an interest rate up to 6% per annum, 0.5% per annum extra return for the senior citizens is there. Then the insurance, the deposit insurance of rupees 5 lakh is also there on this FD. Apart from this, low premature withdrawal charges of only 1%. So all of these are basically the lucrative benefits that are being offered to the depositors so that they can put their money under the green fixed deposit initiative of the bank, so that it can further lend this money to the individuals or basically the companies which are engaged in the sustainable development projects. Moving ahead, which country has launched the world's first dual mode vehicle known as DMV that can run on roads as well as rail tracks? So it's Japan. So here you can see, if you can clearly see here, so these are the tires for the roads and these are for the tracks. रेलवे ट्रैक्स. सो दिस मेक्स इट कंफर्टेबल इन बोथ काइंड ऑफ मोड्स. इट कैन ऑल्सो स्मूथली रन ऑन द रोड्स एज वेल एज ऑन रेलवे ट्रैक्स. नेक्स्ट इज हु हैज बीन अपॉइंटेड एज द एमडी एंड सीईओ ऑफ पंजाब नेशनल बैंक. अतुल कुमार गोयल इज द राइट आंसर. Who has won the Mother Teresa Memorial Award for Social Justice 2021? So guys, here all the three options that are mentioned here, Anil Prakash Joshi, Vidyut Mohan, Pradima Pandey, all of them have won this award. So option E is the right answer. Now, first of all, this Mother Teresa Memorial Award is given by Harmony Foundation to individuals or the firms who have contributed towards environmental sustainability. So that's the criteria to get this award. Now, the people who have received this award are themselves working a great deal towards environmental conservation. So first we have Dr. Anil Prakash Joshi, who himself won the Padma Bhushan for the last year in 2021 for his environmental conservation efforts. Then second one is Vidyut Mohan, who has already won the Earthshot Prize. Then the third one is Ridhima Pandey, who is the environmental activist from Uttarakhand. Okay. So guys, those were our questions for today. Now the time has come for the GK Factory section. Now let me inform you that from now onwards, I'm going to be your tour guide. I'm going to give you a ride of Uttarakhand and show you what kind of beautiful places are there. But the students who are thinking to shut down this video, to just go away from this video, guys, you are going to have a loss, because in this section I'm not only going to talk about the beautiful places, but towards the end of the session you will yourself assess that yes, not only the places but the places, because of their beauty, are important, but they have the examination relevance as well. So let's begin. Okay, so here you can yourself see what kind of a beautiful places are these. This is India's first forest healing center at Rani Khet in Almora district, and this one is the highest herbal park which is in Uttarakhand. So both of them are really, really beautiful. But this is not the end, it's just the beginning. I'm going to show you, seriously, they are very beautiful places. And when I was preparing this PPT for you all, I was so enticed to go to Uttarakhand, because these places are really very beautiful. Okay, India's largest open air fernery at Rani Khet. Again, this is the fernery, but this is a little bit a blur picture, but I only got this on Google, which can be authenticated. Next one is this. This is Palmatium. So here you can see the palm trees, and this is really beautiful and serene. Next is the Grass Conservatory, and this is India's first grass conservatory. So can you see so many things that are India's first, that are very close to nature, are in Uttarakhand? Next is India's first glass floor suspension bridge. So here you can, if you can see it clearly, so this is the glass floor bridge. From this bridge you can see what is there in the valley, down in the valley. So it is basically a replacement of the Lakshman Jhula in Rishikesh over River Ganga. Okay, so this is India's first lichen park. So here I have put some information for you. So in the world, lichen species are around 20,000, okay? And the lichen species in India that are found are 2,740, and out of these, over 600 are found in Uttarakhand alone. So that's entire thing makes this park all the more important from exam point of view and from nature point of view as well, for the tourist for the people who love tourism. India's first snow leopard conservation center is also there in Uttarakhand. Next is this, India's first museum on Ganga River, which is again at Chandighat in Haridwar in Uttarakhand again. So this is India's first Ganga River museum. Then we have India's longest single lane motorable suspension bridge on Tehri Lake. So this is single lane, Okay, one lane is there. Obviously, you can see motorable suspension bridge. Next is, so can you see that the list of the sites is not ending? Next is India's first moss garden at Kumaon's Nainital district. So this is again India's first moss garden in Uttarakhand. India's first pollinator park at Haldwani in Nainital district. Again, India's first pollinator park in Uttarakhand. This is Suryadhar Lake at Doiwala, Dehradun district. So this is the lake that has been created, and this is the Assam Conservation Reserve. So guys, so far I hope that you have got an idea that this is just not the tourism guide that I am giving you. This is just not the itinerary that I am providing you. All of these sites are important from the exam point of view because they have been in the news, particularly because they were launched or inaugurated last year, and secondly, they are India's first. So many firsts of India are located in Uttarakhand. So all of these things make this entire thing all the more important. So regarding the Suryadhar Lake, I have already told you, it was also inaugurated in November 2020. This Assam Conservation Reserve, this is Uttarakhand's first Ramsar site, okay? This is Uttarakhand's first Ramsar site located on the banks of Yamuna River in Garhwal region. Now guys, your task is to tell me the total number of Ramsar sites in India. Moving ahead, so we have discussed so many first about Uttarakhand. Let's discuss the summer capital of Uttarakhand also. So Garhsel is the summer capital, and it was again declared in March 2020. So not a very old news, okay? The winter capital is Dehradun. So apart from Uttarakhand, Jammu Kashmir also has two capitals, Srinagar and Jammu, the summer and winter capital. Okay, so this is the Corbett Tiger Reserve of Uttarakhand, which is very famous. But apart from being famous as a tiger reserve, this Corbett Tiger Reserve also has its importance, which can be cited from this report, Status of Tigers, Co-Predators and Prey in India 2020 report. According to this report, the maximum number of tigers in India were found in the Corbett Tiger Reserve. So it has the highest population of the tigers in India as per 2020 report. So guys, here are some of the static facts related to the state of Uttarakhand, like the state flower, which is Brahma Kamal, state bird, Himalayan Molan, state tree, which is Boran, butterfly, which is Papilio binor, which is also known as common peacock. Now guys, this reminds me that there is golden bird wing, which is India's largest butterfly. Okay, now this is the female of this species were found in Uttarakhand, and they are India's largest, basically they are India's largest butterfly, and the male of this species was found in Meghalaya. So from this point of view also, from this butterfly point of view also, this is important. This state again became important. Okay, then the state animal is white-bellied musk deer, and the state language is Hindi. Now guys, this slide talks about some of the important rivers of Uttarakhand. Now Uttarakhand is one state that is hub of many rivers, okay, rivers, tributaries, etc. So I have just put out the most important rivers, the rivers that have the cultural significance also per se. Alaknanda, Bhagirathi, Bilangana, Ganga, Yamuna, Mandakini. So again, these are just the names. The entire course of these rivers and their tributaries, this is something that we can deal with in a separate session. Okay, then we have lakes. Uttarakhand is also famous for its lakes. Again, I have just put out the most important ones, so don't consider it as an exhaustive list of the lakes or the rivers. Okay, I'm just not taking any kind of guarantee here. So it's just the lakes which are most important. Nainital, Tehri Lake, Bheem Tal, Satopanth Tal Lake, Suryadhar Lake that we just talked about, Vasuki Tal Lake. And these are some of the dams which you can read on your own. Now, this slide is very, very important. And before discussing this slide, let me tell you that yes, it is an exhaustive list of the GI products of Uttarakhand state. So here you can see that all of these are the products that have already received the GI tag. But when did they receive the tag? It's as early as October 2021. Okay. So I hope that this has grabbed your attention. So do listen to me very carefully. First is this Kamaon Chayura oil. Then Munsayari Rajma Bhotia Dan, which is a rug prepared by the Bhotias, which is a nomadic community of Uttarakhand. Then this Aipan. So this is basically an art made on special occasions, which you can yourself see how beautiful it is. Ringal craft. Okay, so here you can see that they are prepared from the bamboo strands. Then we have Uttarakhand's Thulma. This is basically a blanket prepared from a locally sourced fabric. Then copper products of Uttarakhand and Tejpatta. Now Tejpatta did not receive the GI tag in October 2021. It has its relevance in the fact that it was the first product from Uttarakhand to get the GI tag. Okay, so these are the products of GI tag, okay, that have already received the GI tag. Now this is the last slide that talks about Uttarakhand. He's the governor of Uttarakhand, Gurmeet Singh. Again, the appointment is not very old, it's very recent. Now, since Uttarakhand is also going to witness elections in February next year, therefore, I just did not put the name of the CM here. So guys, here, I hope that you have enjoyed the entire tour of Uttarakhand. And at the same time, do not just get lost in the beauty of the places that I have mentioned. Just remember the facts also, because they are India's first in many senses. Okay, so on that note, I am going to say goodbye to you all. If you like the video, do not forget to subscribe to the channel, hit the bell notification, share this video among your friends. Thank you so much.